Hello everyone, this is a demo how to implement infinite scroll in your Frontity project. In order to do that, we have just released a couple of Frontity hooks to make it really easy. We released one for the archives and we released another one for the post types. They are really similar. But first of all, let's take a look at how they look like. We implemented them in our blog in frontity.org/blog. So if we start scrolling through the archive, we can see that it's going to, at some point when it's going to load the second page, you can see that the URL also changes. So if I keep scrolling, it's going to load the third one. And at this point, we decided to stop the infinite scroll and to create a button to load more. And if I click on load more, it's going to load the page four. This is because we added a setting to decide if you want to stop the infinite scroll at some point, if you don't want to stop it, make it infinite. So if users keep scrolling, it's going to load the next page and it's going to load the next page. But you can also decide to stop it in the third page, in the fourth page, or in the fifth page, or whatever you want, basically. In this case, we decided to stop it in the third, but you can select whatever you want. And the same way it works for the archive, it works for the post types. They are different hooks, but they were really similar. So here we are in a post. If we start scrolling and we finish the article, it's going to load the next one. And if we keep scrolling, it's going to load the next one until we reach the limit we define. That is going to create the load more button, and you can load them manually. Here we set the limit also to 3, but they could be different for the archive and the post types. So this is how it works. Let's see how to implement it in your project. In order to show you, I created a new Frontity project with Mars Theme, the one you get from npx Frontity Create. I'm running it in localhost, and as you can see, if I start scrolling, it's not going to load more pages because we didn't implement the infinite scroll yet. So let's see how to implement it. This is the code base. We have the different components. This is the normal Mars theme. So let's see how to implement this in the post and in the archives. Let's start, for example, with the posts. We can see that in this case, we have a post component, and in the index, we are importing it. And we are saying if data is post type, you are going to use the post component. So let's turn this post component into a post list with the infinite scroll. So first of all, I recommend you to create a new folder for this. Let's name it post. Of course, this is not mandatory, but I think it helps to keep the code organized. And let's move the post component here because we are going to reuse it for each post in the list. But we don't want to load one post. We want to create a list. So let's create a new component named post list. And here we are going to use the infinite scroll hook. So first of all, let's import it. You can import it directly from Frontity hooks. So we can say import post type infinite scroll from Frontity hooks. This way you can already use this. So let's create a new component, post list, for example, and let's use it. In this hook, there are different properties, but let's start with the most simple one. From this, we can use the posts from use post type infinite scroll. And this post variable is going to be an array with all the posts that we want to use. So we can already consume this data. Let's create a component. We can wrap all the list in a container, in a div. And as I said, the posts is an array, so we can go through each of these posts and do whatever we want. In each item, we have different properties. We have a key. As we are in a React array, we need a key. We have also the link of the post, so we can consume this data from Frontity state. We have also an isLast property to know if it's the last post in the array. You can do whatever you want. And we have a wrapper that is a React component to wrap each post. So with this, let's add, for example, some logic. We can use the wrapper where we have to pass the key. Oh, sorry. Where we have to pass the key. And here we are going to reuse the post component we already have. So with the author, with date, it's already in the original Mars theme. So let's reuse it. And we have to pass the link property with the link where the post has to fetch the data. But this link property is still not defined in the original post component. So let's add it. We can pass here the link. And for the data, instead of using state.router.link, we can use this new property. So we can save this. And in the post list, we have to import the post component because I didn't do it from post. And we have to export the post list, port fault, post list, and we have to import connect. And here, for example, we are not using is last, but we could say if it isn't the last post, let's add a new XR to separate the post. So this could be a really simple example of the post list, but just with that, it works. We have to import, here it returns an error because in the index file, we are importing the post, but we don't want to import the post. We want the post list. So let's import the post list instead. And here, instead of using the post, let's use the post list. So with this, if we go to our localhost project, if we go to a post, if we start scrolling, it's going to load the next post. And if we keep scrolling, it's going to load the next post. And if we keep scrolling, it's going to load the next post. We didn't set any limit, so it's going to keep doing that until the user stops scrolling. So as you can see, with just this code, it works. Let's add now a bit more logic. For example, we can add the is limit. Well, first, you can select what to do when it's fetching. For example, add an icon as we saw in our blog. So you have the is fetching property from the use post type infinite scroll. And here you can do whatever you want. We already have a loading component, so we can reuse it. I'm going to import it. Import loading from loading, and we can reuse this component. And here we can say after the posts, if is fetching, we're going to return a loading component. And I'm going to add a container for this because if not, it's not going to look well. And I have to create it. Style deep. And let's add some CSS properties so we make sure it shows properly. With 100%, let's align it to the center. And I don't know, let's add some margin, for example. And I have to import the style because we use it. So style. Okay, so with this, we are saying that for the infinite scroll, when I reach the first post and I finish reading the article, well, it's going too fast, so we cannot watch it. But we watch it in the Frontity blog, we added that loading component. So we can keep adding more functionalities. And as I said, we can set a limit. We can use the isLimit property. And in order to, well, similar to the isLimit, we have another property that is named isError, that if it returns an error, you can do whatever you want. We can load another button, for example. And we have an action, fetchNest, that you can use in the isLimit if you that we will see. If you reach the limit, you can create a button that on click, you fetch the next post. So this is what it is for. Let's import this to our component and we can use it. We can reuse it, for example, in this new container And here we can say, okay, if is limit or is error, we are going to load the button. And in this button, we are saying, okay, if the user clicks the button, you are going to fetch text. For example, here we could say if is error, you are going to return something failed. Try. And if it's not error, it's going to be is limit, so you can return load more. Well, let's add some styles to the button, because if not, it's going to look weird. Let's create a new style component. Styled button. Let's add some colors, background blue, color white. I don't know, let's for example add position, I think we need this, position relative, no border, for example. And instead of using a command button here, let's use our style component. Okay, so we added this new logic. We have to define a limit, of course. Say limit 3, as we have in our block. Okay, so we have this now. If go to this post, for example, I start scrolling, is going to load the second one. If I start scrolling, I keep scrolling, is going to load the third one. And in the third one, is going to stop. And well, we can see here the button is a bit ugly, but it's here. And if I click the button, it's going to load the next one. And that's it. That's how we implemented it in our blog. It's this easy to implement it in Mars theme or in your project. Of course, you can add more logic to this. Of course, this button could be improved, but with this, you can do whatever we want. So let's see how to implement this now in our archives. For the archives in the Mars theme, we are using list, this list component. But really, this is not the list we want now with the infinite scroll. This is a list page, so we can rename it to a list page that we will be reusing. And the imports list page and list page. And we don't need the pagination anymore, so let's remove it. Save this. And let's create a new list component to use the archive infinite scroll hook. So here in the list, as it's really similar, I'm going to copy this one and I'm going to adapt it. The one we use for the post types, I'm going to copy and I'm going to reuse it. So instead of using the post type infinite scroll, we are going to use the archive infinite scroll. Here, instead of an array of posts, we are going to get an array of pages. Name this list. And here we have to use the archive. Here, instead of going through the post array, we can go through the pages array. And instead of using the post component, we can use the, I don't know how I named it, list page. And we have to change the import as well. List page from list page. So, okay, let's change this. You can see that this is really, really similar. Instead of using the post array, we are using pages array, and we are changing the imports that we need. But, okay, and here, no, this change, I don't want it. And now if we go to our homepage, and I start scrolling, we can see that it's going to load the second page at some point. If I keep scrolling, okay, scrolling the image. Okay, now it loaded the second page. And if I keep scrolling, it's going to load the third one. And at the end, it's going to show the load more button. And if I click on it, it's going to load the next page, and that's it. This not only works for the homepage, it will also work for the different archives, like the categories or the tags. So this is it. I hope you understood how the Infinite Scroll works and how easy it's to implement. I created a code sandbox with this code. You can also take a look at the code in our web for frontity.org/blog. That the implement, as I said, the Infinite Scroll is implemented there, so you can take a look. And yeah, that's it. If you have any questions, feel free to share them in the community. You can also take a look at the feature discussions, where everything is explained better and all the different properties are explained in detail. So I encourage you to take a look there.